Electrical hazards are any dangerous conditions associated with electricity. Exposure can lead to injury or worse, death. There are four primary dangers associated with electrical hazards. First is electric shock, which is characterized by a small amount of current that can cause muscle contractions or respiratory paralysis. Next is electrocution, which is a fatal electric shock that often happens instantly and with no warning. Electrical burns occurs when electricity travels through the body and can manifest on the skin and internally. Lastly, an arc flash is the sudden discharge of electrical energy, releasing heat up to 35,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, here are the six common electrical hazards you need to watch out for. First are overloaded circuits. Plugging too many devices into a single circuit can cause overheating and even electrical fires. It's also a major cause of equipment damage and increases the risk of electrical shock. Exposed wiring is another serious hazard. Wires can become exposed from wear and tear, poor installation, or external damage. Contact with an exposed wire can lead to shock, burn, or even fire. Improper grounding occurs when electrical equipment is not correctly grounded and excess electricity has no safe path to the ground. This can cause electric shock or electrocution, particularly in wet conditions. Overhead power lines are a hidden danger, especially in construction sites. Contact with live lines can lead to severe electrocution, arc flash, or fire. Loose connections may seem like a minor issue, but they can lead to overheating, intermittent power loss, or even electrical fires. Make sure all connections are tight and secure. Inadequate wiring is when wires are too small or improperly installed to handle the required electrical load. This can lead to overheating, short circuits, and damage to sensitive equipment. Before we move on, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel for more safety tips and industry insights like this one. So, how can you prevent these electrical hazards? The first step is to conduct regular inspections. Look for wear, damage, or overheating to fix them before accidents happen. Use personal protective equipment, or PPE, such as insulated gloves, arc-rated clothing, and face shields. These safety gears can protect you against electrical shock and arc flash. Next is performing lockout-tagout, or LODO, which is critical when servicing electrical systems. These procedures prevent the accidental release of energy, ensuring that machinery is properly de-energized and isolated. For areas where water and electricity may meet, like kitchens or outdoor spaces, GFCIs are essential. These devices cut off power when they detect a fault, protecting employees from electrical shock. Moisture, humidity, and poor ventilation can increase the risk of electrical faults. Keep your equipment dry, reduce humidity, and make sure there's proper airflow to prevent overheating. Regular training is important to keep everyone aware of the risks and how to avoid them. Train employees on identifying electrical hazards, using PPE, and knowing how to respond in emergencies. Here's a rundown on the strategies to prevent electrical hazards. Found this video helpful? Like and subscribe for more. See you on the next one.